Support is something that must first be earned and must never be taken for granted. The ability to prop each other up when things look bleak separates a champion from an also-ran. The more a team sticks together, the easier it is to separate that team from the pack. And if at first you don't succeed, you must try again. Canada gets another shot at the Pan Am Championship next. Ontario's capital of Toronto is the capital of rugby this weekend. Canada takes on Argentina in Pan Am Championship action. Hello everybody, I'm Craig McEwen and welcome to Fletcher's Field here in Markham, Ontario. Now at the start of this tournament, Canada had but one goal in mind, and that was to beat the United States to earn a berth at this summer's Epson Cup in Japan. Well, last Saturday in Kingston, they did just that, beating the Eagles 19-10 in Kingston. It was a huge win, but you have to think in the back of their minds, they were also looking forward to today's match with Argentina, the only country to ever win this Pan Am Championship, and the all three times they have done that, they have beaten Canada. So if we take a look at the standings, here's how things shape up heading into this important match. Argentina and Canada both have perfect 2-0 records, but if you look at the points, Argentina is on top because they have scored at least four tries in each of their two games. So what does that mean for Canadian rugby fans? Well, it's a must-win contest for David Clark's side, but the coach thinks he knows how to get by Argentina.
World-renowned scrummages, hot-blooded continentals, emotional, and sometimes lose their structure and their cool. If we can frustrate them, and remain composed, and keep our game in good shape, then there's a chance that we can take them to the scoreboard and have our name on top at the end of the day.
And something else that should help Canada today is the fact that Gonzalo Longo from Argentina is out of this tournament after punching Dan Lyle in the face. Lyle suffered three broken bones and a lot of stitches. Gonzalo, well, he got a two-week suspension. If you throw in the fact that Canada is also fielding its biggest lineup, its most important lineup for this match, things do bode well. We'll have more on that, plus our broadcast team of Gary Johnston and Mark Doherty will be along to give you their thoughts on this match. So don't go anywhere. Lots of rugby action still to come here from Fletcher's Field in Markham. For the fourth time in history, the Pan Am Championship is on the line. The three times before, Argentina has come out on top with Canada being runner-up. Will this be the day Canada finally wins it all? Well, let's find out from our Mark Doherty and Gary Johnston. Gentlemen,
thanks very much, Craig. And as Craig said, a very pivotal match. Both teams undefeated in this tournament. Canada looking for big things. And as you like to always point out, it starts up front. And are you looking forward to this matchup? Bichard, Bonorino, Deschazal against Snow, Teal, and Dunkley.
It'll be a war out there today against Argentina, but the battle will take place between the packs. Argentina will lose games to major rugby-playing countries, but rarely do they lose the battle of the scrums. Canada will have a tough task today holding Argentina. They must do that if they expect to win.
So we'll be looking to the battle of the packs, but also in internationals, goal kicking, incredibly important. Therefore, are you surprised that Bobby Ross isn't starting for Canada today? Scott Stewart will field the kicking duties for Canada.
Well, I think that Bobby Ross is the top goal kicker in Canada, and he's not playing. He needs the experience. He's going to play against England, hopefully. You need the goal kicking to win the games, and if Scotty Stewart can do the job, fair play. But I think Bobby is number one, and I'm surprised he has not been selected to play against Argentina today.
And also throughout this tournament, Canada's offense has sputtered a little bit. It's been a bit sporadic, but one thing that has been consistently strong is their defense, and they'll need more of that today.
Right. The defense against the United States was great. Against Uruguay was good. Argentina, there must be no holes in the straight line defense. The Argentinian backs may not be allowed to penetrate against Canada. If they do, Canada will be in trouble.
So the match is set. Argentina, Canada coming up. We'll be back with the starting lineups and the anthems. More on Sportsnet right after this.
USA. And welcome back to Fletcher's Fields, Markham, Ontario, the site of today's match, Argentina-Canada. Alongside me, as always, Gary Johnston, former national coach, national player. And Gary, what a tilt today, both undefeated in this year's 2001 Pan American Rugby Championship Series. You couldn't ask for a better matchup in the final.
Well, Argentina has even brought some fans with them, and they've got the legend, some of the famous players of the past are here on a tour, and they've joined. And here comes the Canadian team led by Al Sharon. Do they look ready?
And this is a Canadian side that we saw, for the most part, play strongly against the Eagles, defeating the Eagles in the first match as we look at the opening lineups.
Well, the only major change, of course, is Captain Al Sharon has arrived back. He wasn't there against the Eagles. He goes to the blindside flanker and takes the captaincy over from Gregor Dixon, who did a good job. Aslan goes to the wing, and they like Williams at fullback, so he stays there. Argentina.
And once again, we talked about the pack strength of Argentina. That will be something that we'll be watching closely in today's match.
This is the strongest team that Argentina can field, minus the number 8, who was Gonzalez Largo, who has been suspended for 2 weeks for a punch on Dan Lyle, the American number 8. This is Al Kemp, and also American from Chicago.
And now, with the National Anthem of Canada, Marnie Del Wo.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all the sons come. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
The anthems out of the way, and there's the weather here in Markham. Slightly overcast now, 15 degrees, and a very strong cross-the-field wind. And look at Buenos Aires, 20 degrees, partly cloudy, 10-kilometer wind. So not too far apart in terms of the weather conditions, but what an exciting match today, Gary. Argentina Pumas, Canada, the final for all the marbles, this year's 2001 Pan American Rugby Championship.
Well, the stage has been set. It looks good. The field looks good. The people of Markham have done a great job. The people of Ontario have done a great job setting this up. The only factor that has to be considered is the cross breeze that's coming towards us, towards our cameras. Scotty Stewart getting ready. He'll do the kicking duties today. A difficult day for kickers with this cross breeze. The referee, as you say, is Mr. Al Klemp. He's from the Chicago Rugby Union. He's neutral. He's the USA. Eduardo Balaggio is the touch judge. He's from Uruguay. Captain. David Steele from Ontario. And the fourth official.
Captain.
actually is John Smith. So if someone gets sent to the sin bin, John Smith will take care of him.
So we're underway, the final match, Argentina Pumas, Canada, and the final of the Pan American Rugby Championship Series. And Atsugo Dande setting things up early. Pichot moving the ball wide. Pumas hammering it down and a huge kick by Conte Pome, who's wearing the scrum cap now. As we have a look at Sam Bussetti. So first line out of the match.
Stay out. Nice and wide.
Pat Dunkley back at hooker for Canada.
He wants another ball. Ball's a little slick. Where's the second ball? Okay. Calm down. The first line out is always very tense. Pat Dunkley, very famous person now after surviving the Fleshing disease. David Clark, head coach of the national team. He has great hopes for this young team. Will they produce today?
Dunkley for Canada.
That's a good throw.
First line out and stolen by the Pumas. Taken quickly by Deschazelle. Pumas keeping it tight. Pichot looking to link with Fernandez. Back inside.
Gotta go. Get away.
Canada will be penalized.
Let him go.
Zal Charon came through. So an early opportunity here for Conte Pome to go for goal. A good test of his kicking ability as there is a very strong wind coming across the width of the field.
He has kicked quick well in this tournament. He is a world-class goal kicker. The Argentinian team looked very weak against the Pumas. They made lots of errors, lots of mistakes. Looked much better against the Americans in the midweek game. And of course, this is the game that everyone's looking forward to, the two undefeated teams.
Conte Pome for Argentina, give the Pumas the early lead. He squibs this one off the side of the foot, nowhere near the posts. Williams will touch it down in the in-goal area, so Canada dodges an early one. Dixon to Stewart. And I think we might see this quite often today, but this kick, Gary, not quite deep enough, and here come the Pumas on the counter. Ball hops just in front of Sean Foth. And he got away a late kick. It's partially blocked. Pumas have the ball. Inside the Canadian half. Pichot waits. Alvarez picks and drives. In comes Deschazelle. This is good work by the Pumas. But it's stolen by Teal. He's looking for support. Dixon in there as Snow goes to dig it out. And it pops out to Nags. He straight arms through the tackle of Camardon. Stewart with the advantage being played. Hoists this one deep. Nobody back for Argentina. Bartolucci is back. And a huge kick as Scotty Stewart took full advantage of the advantage for Canada, Gary.
Well, it's got the crosswind there. And that was a beautiful kick. And Canada can put Argentina under pressure inside the 22. Canada will clearly put up both jumpers here and pressure the throw by Argentina.
So Canada with a great opportunity here to try and steal the ball. Vichard.
Again, the wind blowing into this corner.
Eduardo, your call. I'm in. Only up. Stay out.
Vichard goes to the front. Argentina under pressure.
Go.
But Pichot able to get the ball out with the right foot, but this will not find touch as it goes infield. Sean Foth up to take it strongly and hangs on. And now he has the support of the forwards coming around. Canada moving it wide. Stewart to Cannon. Looking back inside for support. And there's Stewart. If he can get it wide, they have Freddie Aslett outside the speedster. Seven star and oh! Just missing the connection with Irvine is, but Canada looking dangerous early and rewarded with a penalty.
There's a knock on early by Argentina. Earlier in the game, Jeff Williams saying, that was your uncle, just settling down here. Both teams kept up. Beautiful play here. John Cannon coming through, holding his balance, looking for support. There's the looping. Scott Stewart, nice move on his opposite number. Freddie Adson, the speedster, cuts inside, turns around. We see the knock on there. Taken with one hand, set scrum Canada. They've given a penalty, and it could also be, oh, he's going to go to the bin. He's got to go to the bin. And here's him trying to talk it out of it. This is Augustus Pichot, a deliberate knock on that close to the line. He's going to go to the bin. That's 10 minutes.
So a huge break, as I believe Alvarez will go to the sin bin. What a break for Canada early in this match against Argentina.
Well, what a mistake by Argentina. They deliberately knocked the ball on inside the 22 when Canada's scoring play is on, and he's been punished for 10 minutes. How will Canada take advantage of this 10-minute man advantage?
Rimas Alvarez will sit for 10. Scott Stewart, chance here for Canada to get on the board with three, just outside the Pumas 22.
But an extremely difficult kick because of the breeze.
So after the penalty attempt, Canada will play with a man advantage for 10 minutes. Big kick for Scott Stewart. Good look at it from behind Stewart. The wind coming from his right. He has the distance, but it falls left of the post, so dropout 22 for the Pumas. Scotty Stewart will not be happy with that attempt. Now down to Craig McEwen.
Thank you, Mark. David Clark talking this week, he was the first to admit that his team probably didn't play very well against Uruguay. But the interesting point he did make was the fact that they did find a way to win, and that good teams do that, and that he was pleased with the fact that his side seems to be coming together, and he's really looking forward to see what his best players can do this afternoon against Argentina.
Get away, get around! Back up, guys.
Once again, the restart by the Pumas, taken quickly by Martin. Crossfield kick by the Argentine standoff, and seeing that Williams and Foth, miscommunication there as Williams came up, bobbled the ball out of touch, so it'll be Pumas line out right on the halfway mark.
This is the knock on, deliberate knock on inside the 22 that resulted in the penalty.
So a good look at the line out. Richard with the put in for the Pumas, finds his man. Sam Bucetti up to take that for Argentina. Show looking for Bartolucci, finds him. Bartolucci with some space back inside. Good work by Dixon and Dunkley. Dande keeping things tight. Show out wide. The up and under hoisted. Williams comes up to take it, but it's taken well by Conte Pome. So Argentina still with possession outside the Canadian 22 as Bichard digs in. Pichot back to his standoff, who attempts a drop kick, and a huge drop kick, and it's good. So out of good pressure by the Pumas, it is Argentina that takes the early lead, 3-0. And a great drop goal by the Argentine standoff puts the Pumas in the early lead. Good ball retention by the Pumas, resulting in that drop kick, drop goal. Scotty Stewart hits this deep, it'll bounce out. So the Pumas, by not fielding that in the air, have given up a line out inside their 22, right, although it will be theirs.
Well, they've ruled this line out so far, and Canada must put pressure on them. I mean, they've got to get their players up ahead of. They've won three lineups, Canada's won none. So this is the time, guys. Get the players up, count the numbers, put some pressure on them. Make that throw be spot on. You can't give them possession.
So some pressure here on Juan Jose Vechar.
Good throw.
He overthrows his man, but it's cleaned up by Rolando Martin, the veteran Puma. 62 international appearances for the Pumas. As Canada's penalized offside by Gregor Dixon. So that's cleared by the Argentine standoff.
It's a lovely drop goal. You remember he's kicking into a crosswind that's coming right into his, into that ball, into his face. It's a very, very good kick.
Look, that's a good gap. So you're not near, fellas.
Line out, Argentina. 10-meter mark. Bouchard goes to the front this time. It's collected nicely by Roldan. Drives on. Once again, Canada with the man advantage, as the Pumas do have a player in the sin bin. But so far, Argentina able to control. Fake with Conte Pome. Bartolucci comes through. Pichot to De Chazal. Pichot coming back to the blind side. Quick hands. Unfortunately, Sambu said he couldn't hang on to it, so
that was tipped here, guys.
It was tipped, the referee saying, so they'll bring it back. Scrum down Argentina.
First scrum. Hey, listen up. No, we're not near.
Now, Kemp, this is obviously a point that we focused on, and he wants to have a chat with the front rows before anything happens. Argentina's coming in before he says engage.
Before the engage and they barged in.
Yes. They must wait until Al Kemp calls them in. David Clark used an interesting term, the hot-blooded Continentals. And Argentina does have a reputation that if things aren't going their way, that everything breaks out and lose concentration. So,
as we look at some of the previous pair of results, Argentina obviously, Gary, having the upper hand, that close one back in 95. But
right, but after that they almost doubled Canada both times. The one in 95 was all goal kicks, I think, almost for Canada, and a few tries by Argentina. So we expect a much better result today.
So we look at the Argentine coach, but Dunkley with the line out finds his man Teal. Stewart fakes the back inside, and here comes Sean Foth in from the blind side, but we've seen that called quite a few times in this tournament so far, Gary, that crossing creating the obstruction, the team penalized for it.
Right, if you go in front of the ball carrier and you cause a defender who has a chance to make the tackle, if you impede his progress, then that's obstruction. So goes Scotty Stewart coming across, and there we go, John Cannon coming back inside. Now, whether that player, the determination is whether that player had a chance to tackle Sean Foth or not. If he had no chance, there should be no call. But you see the lineout stats. This has been significant. We'll not be able to put pressure on the Pumas lineout. We must do that.
The shot for the Pumas. They're inside their own half. He looks to the back and overthrows the mark, and Dixon able to throw it back to Snow. And he was going for a rumble as he threw down De Chazal. So Snow trying to make his presence felt early.
Again, a scrum half. See if the scrum is waiting for the call in. That was good.
Bring it.
Now, I know the referee's a little nervous at the beginning, but we've had no flow to this game whatsoever yet, and we're hoping the referee will allow the game to move.
No, he stood up.
He never called them in. The referee's inconsistent. He never called them in, and he penalized Argentina for that at the beginning, and this time he penalized John Teal for not going in.
So Miranda with the clearance off the penalty. This one hangs in the wind, but finds touch just outside the Canadian 22. It will be a Puma lineout. Miranda so far has made good on the drop goal. And once again, the Pumas have been without a player for the last 8 or 9 minutes, Gary, and Canada has not been able to capitalize on that.
Not at all. Alvarez is warming up, and once the fourth official gives the referee the okay, he'll come and join. Right now, Canada still has a man advantage. We haven't used that at all.
So the Pumas, who were forced to drop one man off the lineout, still managed to win it. Pichot waits, picked up and driven on by Roldan. Canada waits.
This rolling wall was very effective for Uruguay against Canada, but of course you're facing a much different Canadian team.
As Pichot tried to link with Arango, he's knocked forward, advantage being played, but they'll bring it back now and reset.
Sinbin is over, you heard Mr. Kemp say that.
So Canada had the man advantage for 10 minutes, but unable to capitalize on it. And it's the Argentine Pumas with the early lead, 3-0 in this match. The final of the 2001 Visa Pan American Rugby Championship Series, coming to you from Fletcher's Fields, Markham, Ontario.
Oh, this is going to be terrible. We've got to get this thing sorted out. We don't want to whistle on every single set scrum. That was Canada's first set scrum. They have a free kick because Argentina came in early once again before the word engage.
We talked about it off the top of the show, Gary. The meaning of the packs and those front rows critical in that engagement. And now both sides, both scrums have been penalized as Alcheron, the captain for Canada, takes it into contact and produces. Scotty Stewart's kick is blocked, and Conte Pome manages to hang on and link with his prop. Dishes out. Argentina on the attack. Conte Pome, nice flip pass back inside. And the Pumas with the advantage.
Got a reaction. That was a great hit by Ryan Banks. Clean hit. And the Argentinian player reacted to that. Now there's got to be a call from the sideline here.
So right now, Canada being penalized, but that may be reversed as the touch judges, Gary, are able to call penalties.
The referee is a sole judge. He will talk to his touch judge. So we see here, there's a hit by Banks. It's a solid hit. As he gets up, he gets a shot over on the back of the head.
Conte Pome not happy with the finishing tackle by Banks, reacts.
Well, rugby's a contact sport, and if you're not prepared to see some contact without getting upset, you better choose something else. Now this is the Uruguayan official.
In 15.
14
for punching. 14 red. The mark will be on the 22. 15 in. I need your 14, please.
So they were talking about Freddie Aslan throwing a punch. And I didn't see it, but obviously the Puma player receiving some attention for a cut on the left side of his eye.
As well.
No, I did not.
Listen to me.
I didn't see the punch.
You're the third man in on a fight. You would have gone nowhere if you'd have stayed out. My touch judge had you for punching. I know. It's getting, okay, it'll be a sin.
He's going to get a card. He's going to the bin for 10 minutes.
It's that way, okay?
There's the bin. And I didn't see that mark at all. I saw two Argentinians around Ryan Banks. And unless I missed something, I didn't see Fred Adson throw a punch at all.
So it was indeed Conte Pome.
So here's the replay. You have to watch Ryan Banks the back with 12. Where's 14? Where's Freddie Aslan? There's Freddie Aslan there. Not really a punch. He drove in and grabbed the Argentinian player.
More or less cleaned him out, but third man in, I believe they were saying. But
well, there was two men on Ryan Banks. Freddie Aslan, doesn't matter. The referee's a penalty, and he's in the bin for 10 minutes.
So while the Pumas were a man short for 10 minutes early in this match, now Canada will have to struggle through being a man short as Conte Pome will try and put three more up for the Pumas. He struck it solidly and it's through for three. So the Pumas leading Canada 6-0. Early first half action.
So far in the game, Mark, no flow in the game whatsoever. And hopefully we'll get a better game. We're almost 20 minutes into the half. And Canada hasn't really had the ball much to show their attacking ability. Their type of game plan, the game plan is a wide, expansive, ball in hand played at a brisk pace. They have not been able to do that because of the many whistles and the lack of possession.
And Gary, and while we saw Canada open this tournament with a win against the States quite convincingly, it was the Pumas who narrowly escaped with a victory against Uruguay, but they have looked sharper as the weeks progress, and in practices things have seemed to have tightened up throughout the week.
They've gotten better as the tournament went along, as we expected. They've never lost a para tournament, and they are favored today.
Argentina ranked higher in world rankings of rugby than Canada is, but Canada now has stolen the ball, and they'll look to attack. Fairhurst finds Stewart. Irvine tried to link with Cannon, took the ball to ground instead.
Get away, guys! Get away!
Here comes Canada again. Williams trying to nudge this one inbounds, but it goes out on the full, so oh so close, but a mistake by Canada will bring the line out back. Some 15 meters. Argentine line out. So far, the Pumas have been solid in the lineouts. Canada,
they'd be very good, and they've used that rolling maul from the lineout that Uruguay used effectively against Canada. But again, it was a different Canadian team that Uruguay faced.
Bichard trying to go to the front to Alvarez, but overthrows him. But
Tate's got it. Tate stole it.
Canada stole it. Fairhurst, Dixon, Stewart had some space, ran into Miranda. Canada still with the ball as Fairhurst takes to the boots to get it out, and Pichot not liking what Banks was doing, as Banks has somebody's scrum hat in his hands, but not the head with it.
Pichot is the leader, the most experienced player Argentina has, and again, he's not liking what's going on. He's taking it into his own hands, so they're driving him back. Canada's got support there. They've still got the ball. A player comes in from the side. Banks comes in, grabs a head protector. And Pichot comes in from the side, and Banks throws an elbow. So, you know, Banks is a guy that will get under your skin, just like Danny Baugh gets under your skin. And I don't think that's a bad idea. If Banks is going to be the guy that gets in there and stirs things up. We need some energy from Canada now inside the 22-meter line.
So a huge kick by Canada. Now with a great opportunity inside the Argentine 22. Dunkley with the line out. Going to the back and overthrows Dixon, and it's picked up by Argentina. Pichot, Miranda, right foot, just gets it past the outstretched arms of Gregor Dixon, but Canada having trouble in the line out. Unable to convert.
Well, both games this week they have had trouble in the lineout, and I know that they worked on that lineout and they put a couple of new things in, and David Clark asked for some shorter lineouts. He wants some shorter lineouts, and this is what they've gone to here. So they're going to work on getting their players up quicker so they can get possession.
And here goes Rolando Martin. 62 caps for Argentina, 18 tries for the Pumas in his career. Williams bobbles as Williams and Foth came up together, and Deschazelle will be seeing that in his nightmares as it just passed his arms and he was away.
Yeah, another scrum. Let's see the bat on the front row. This is something that Argentina prides itself, and they destroyed the Americans in this phase of the game on Wednesday night. Absolutely destroyed the American pack. The Americans, we should say, have won the previous game. They're in third place. Uruguay's in fourth. This is for first and second.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was a call from the sideline saying that Rod Snow had taken the scrum down. He disagrees with that.
So Snow going up against Bonorino, and Snow penalized for pulling down. And that call was made by the touch judge.
So let's watch this. Let's watch the binding. No. It's the other. You look at the right arm of the Argentinian tight head. He pulled the Snow down. That was the wrong call. Canada got shortchanged on that. You watch where the elbows point. You saw who puts the pressure in.
So Canada penalized, but Argentina kicks the touch, gets the line out. Bichard with the line out. This is his man in the front. Advantage being played to the Pumas, though. So knocked forward by Red in the line out. They'll bring it in 15 and scrum down. Great opportunity for the Pumas. Once again, Canada, a man down, one man, Freddie Aslan in the sin bin right now.
Well, that's not going to affect their scrummaging, Mark, but this is one of the key factors we talked about at the beginning of the game is the scrummaging, and Canada will be tested here by Argentina.
So Sambusetti is up. Scrum down Argentina, 5 meters. Line of Canada. The drive's in on is picked up by Dande, who stopped short. Driven back by Banks and Chiron. Canada has the ball. What a turnover by the Canadian defense. Ball sits there as Fairhurst is able to find Stewart, who had to kick it around Rolando Martin, so it's forced to stay inbound, and here comes Tortoni. A little chip through, he gives chase up against Snow, and somehow gets the ball away from Rod Snow, and Argentina still with possession. Miranda, nothing outside, cuts back, still on his feet as Pichot has met outside on the blind side. Conte Pomi ducks underneath Thiel, and here goes in the corner for the score, Sambusetti.
Well, that was a well-conceived try by Argentina. Here we see the build-up. Ball on the ruck, Bruce Pichot quickly moves it out. Again, the straight line defense, players going through Pichot again, second time he's touched the ball, ducks into a tackle of John Tate, goes outside. They have a big number four lock.
And great work by Deschazelle to get this yes. pass away right here as he's going to ground. Great hands by the prop. Gets it out to Sambusetti, who
Sambusetti,
just stretches
yes. in. Sambusetti, there's a mismatch there. Eddie Ferrer is trying to tackle Sambusetti 2 meters from the line.
So Felipe Contepome, now without the scrum cap, will attempt to convert the try. Struck it well, but it'll go off to the left, so he misses the try. Argentina 11, Canada no score. First half action.
Well, Canada has not got off to a good start that David Clark would have liked, so he has reason to be concerned. The next score will be crucial. It's Pichot again, ducking under the tackle of John Tate, breaching the straight line defense. Sean Foth pinching in, Eddie Ferris coming across, making the tackle, but close to the line. A scrum half against the lock, that's a mismatch.
Stewart with the restart as Hugo Dande takes it upfield.
Obstruction, yes. Argentinian players in front obstructing Canadian runners make the tackle. Okay, now this is a kickable kick, and at this point in the game, Freddie Aslan coming back on the field. His 10 minutes is up for the punch. That was like the punch that knocked out Sonny Liston by Muhammad Ali. No one saw it.
8-5, the penalties. You can see. But Scotty Stewart, second shot at goal. Canada wanting to put some points on the board, trailing Argentina 11-0. First half action of the Visa Pan American Rugby Championship Series. And the final game for these two countries, both undefeated so far in this year's tournament. Stewart will have a long look at this as he has to compete with a crosswind from his right.
He's a right-footed kicker, so he's going to put it on that right post and just slide it in. Breeze will slide it in.
Strikes it well, and it's through. So Canada on the board with Scotty Stewart's penalty kick. But Argentina still leading 11-3. First half action.
Canada needed some points. We couldn't have Argentina score again.
So Miranda getting set to restart things for the Pumas. Nice towering dropout kick as the Pumas were up to take that and get possession. Hugo Donde runs into Teal and Dunkley and goes nowhere, but Pichot. Miranda will try the long drop goal, partially blocked, fairly ambitious from where he was on the pitch, and Williams finds touch but not a lot of distance, so he'll be disappointed with that clearance attempt, as this will set up the Pumas lineup on the Canadian 22.
Right, again, watch for the clean possession and the rolling maul. There's a Canadian bench, Boris Stoikos, who I thought played well in his game on Wednesday night. Here are the ball in contact, which we've been following. 113, we lost 3, and we have 1 penalty. So that means we've produced 13 times in contact. Argentinians penalized for men leaving the lineout once it's been set. Ryan Banks, man they love to hate.
So here goes John Cannon, back inside to Irvine.
Leave him alone.
Fairhurst looks for Stewart. Stewart had Chiron inside, but decided to move it wide as Teal is stood up by Alvarez. But once again, Canada produces. Stewart over to the blind side. Had Foth inside. Cannon is up, met quickly by Frontepome. Canada with the drive. Fairhurst, Canada with the advantage. Williams senses the advantage and they'll move it wide. They have a man outside if they can get it. Freddie after the speedster. Good tackle and stolen by Argentina. They'll bring it back though.
Because
fortunately for Canada, because they weren't playing the advantage, so the ball will come back. But anxious moments. Argentina almost in for the try.
Well, that's why Canada ran the ball in that situation. Canadian players looking relieved. That what happened is that the Canada set the maul and Argentina just pulled the maul down. So this is something that the Canada was warned about, not collapsing the maul. They did it many times on Wednesday night and were penalized against Uruguay. And this time Argentina collapsed the maul, advantage to Canada, but the ball thrown away by the right winger, Freddie Asler.
Scotty Stewart with the penalty to kick it out of touch, was unable to do so. Here comes Scortoni, gets past Foth, runs into Eddie Nags. Pichot, Deschazelle out of the wing, taken down by Tate. This is good forward movement by the Pumas, as Donde took it in.
This is Canada's straight line defense. Well, Kemp says advantage.
Canada will be penalized, Argentina with the advantage. They keep hammering away at the Canadian defense. Now they'll call it up, going over the top. So good pressure by the Argentine forwards, forcing Canada into the penalty.
Here's an example why we're in a bit of trouble here. Penalty against Canada. Argentina kicker finds touch inside the 22. Last penalty we had, we didn't find touch, because when you find touch on a penalty, you also get, it's a double penalty, you also get lineup possession. You know, these things have to be done properly, and right now Argentina is doing it properly and Canada is not.
Bichard for the Pumas. Deep inside the Canadian 22, and they take the line out with Sambosetti, and the drive is on.
Advantage, that's a maul, fellas.
Advantage being played once again for the Pumas. They have a free one. Pichot keeps it tight. Bonorino stops short of the line. Pichot once again, Miranda. He'll have a go himself, but he's brought down by Foth. But Argentine on the Canadian goal line.
There's a knock there, penalty's over here.
But they'll bring it back. Advantage was being played, and the Pumas might have another crack. But Miranda's down, so they'll have to wait while they have a man ahead of where the penalty will be marked.
The penalty was against Canada for collapsing the maul, exactly what Argentina did. On the lineout, they allowed Argentina to set the maul, and then as the maul went towards the Canadian goal line, it was pulled down. And Mr. Klemp determined that Canada had pulled it down. So therefore, there was an advantage penalty. So Canada was very lucky that Argentina did not score. And Argentina has called for a set scrum.
So Miranda, a little shaky while he's getting up, as he had to go himself here, was tripped up. And then I think he was...
runs into Scotty Stewart.
Hit by Scotty Stewart. Scotty Stewart made sure he didn't get over the goal line. But now, Gary, a huge scrum for Canada with Argentina pressuring. This is going to be a huge effort for Canada to stop the forward movement here.
It will be. This will be Canada's scrum. We sorely tested. The scrums have to stay up. And let's sit back and enjoy this.
Argentina with the push has collapsed.
No, come here now.
Penalty against Canada.
No,
referee will want to have a word with
new
the front
three.
Rows.
Listen to me. You're defending here. Make sure you're coming straight. Come straight.
See, referees really have no idea what's going on there. They just have to look. Canada was under pressure.
Hit the mark, that's it.
And John Teal's side went down first.
Back up. Woo! Back up. Get him. No, listen.
See, the problem is that most referees are all forwards. There's a mistake by Argentina. They're going to be furious about this.
You sort out your scrum. No.
This is repeat infringement. This is the third time they've been called for doing that. Sin bin soon. Break for Canada. So here we go. The referee must call the teams in. Argentina goes in. Dunkley's not down. Teal's not down. They're not ready. They're waiting for it to be called in. And if they continue to do this, someone's going to the sin bin. I don't know who you'd send off.
This time, however, Scotty Stewart finds touch. So Canada with the line out now, just outside their own 22.
Again, we're using a short line out.
No. No. We didn't have a call in the gap yet.
Referee will bring them back.
Blue.
They have a short lineout. Argentina leading 11-3. First half of action. Final match between these two countries. And the final of the Pan American Rugby Championships. Everything on the line. Stewart with the right foot. Can't find touch. It's in play. Bartolucci waits for it as Sean Foth is up to meet him with Dunkley in support. And Canada, all kinds of pressure, but Pichot somehow slips out. And here comes Argentina on the counterattack. Arango links up with Camardon. Stood up well by Irvine. But the Pumas, great ball retention.
Bring it up. Moving forward. Scrum. Blue.
So Canada with good pressure, but unable to capitalize and force the turnover. So good job by the Pumas in ball retention. Something Canada has done well throughout this tournament, Gary.
A lot depends on your opposition, and something Canada must do well today. We're keeping that stat. We'll keep you informed as the game progresses.
This time the scrum stays up, and Dande takes it on. Argentina content to keep things tight. Good fake by Miranda as Scotty Stewart went flying past, trying for the block of the kick. And here comes Williams, and he's got some speed. Freddie Aslin came in from the scissors.
There's an obstruction call after Jeff Williams made the kick. He was taken out, and the kick is kicked there or where the ball lands, which is actually kickable from Scott Stewart as we're getting very close to the half.
So
here's Jeff Williams.
Canada.
Here's Jeff Williams. There's the kick, and there's the takeout by replacement number 8.
Dunde.
So this
threw his arms up in the air as if he didn't mean to do it, but I think there wasn't much question that he was trying to get in the way of Williams. And now Canada with the line out on the 5-meter line of the Pumas.
Now this is a time where you've asked the referee how long is left, and he's told you. And you know you've got enough time to win a lineout and drive one over. So they chose not to kick for the 3, but go for the 5 at halftime.
So a huge lineout for Canada. Desperate need of a try to get back into this match. The Pumas leading 11-3. Dunkley with the lineout.
Look to Dunkley to go to the front. Oh, he's gone to the back.
And Teal just missed it. And they'll call a knock on by Canada. So in the red zone, not much. You can't get much closer, Gary. And an opportunity lost.
You have to convert that. And on a windy day when it's difficult to go to John Tate at the back of the lineout. There's Mike Schmidt coming down, getting ready for halftime. There'll be a 10-minute halftime break. But you have to convert those. That's a ball that Canada needed. And John Tate was up there. He's an excellent lineup forward. He just wasn't quite on the mark.
Once again, problems with the scrum. Both countries, both teams have been penalized for scrum infractions. But Pichot to Miranda, who had to kick it with the left foot, but manages to get a good kick away. Takes the Pumas outside their 22. But once again, Canada still inside the Argentine half with the line out just outside the 22. We have a look at the
picture of Gonzalez Longo, the suspended player. He got 2 weeks, and Dan Lyle, who got punched, has probably got 3 months till his injury heals.
That's a story in itself in terms of Dan Lyle going back onto the pitch after being punched. More on that in a bit, but here comes Canada as Cannon tries to break through the centers. Links with Irvine, who tosses it back. Argentina tries to kick it through. Ball is alive. No knock on. Pichot to Bartolucci. Sidesteps, inside nags. He's hammered. Once again, the Pumas able to keep the ball in play. Miranda gets a kick away. Still in bounds. Williams inside his 22. Good clearance. He'll take Canada further out. Ball goes into touch, but line out for the Pumas. So Williams starting to settle down. Vishal.
We'll watch for the referee looking at his watch. We're almost at full time here.
Vishal able to find Alvarez. Contepome tries to go through, links with Dande. Banks is there trying to steal the ball and does so, and here comes Snow. And what a straight arm, just wipes out Miranda, and here comes the ball. Banks to Tate out on the backs, and Freddie Aslin took his eyes off the ball for a moment, but Canada trying to regain possession, but now they'll be penalized. Pichot, quick tap, wants to go. Gets the ball out to Contepome, but Irvine was there, and here comes Dande. Argentina with the attack, Canada under pressure. And here comes Bartolucci, he has a gap and has the speed, but a great cross-cover tackle by Fairhurst. Pumas all over Canada, inside the 5-meter line.
Sean Foth has his hands on the ball, he's holding on to it as long as he possibly can. We're on the half.
Biggs, Miranda wanted to go back inside, and a huge hit by Snow as he came up at the head. Pichot, quick tap, wants to go himself, and Pichot just short of the line. Canada under all kinds of pressure, and somehow they got the ball back as Pichot was inches from the goal line, and now Canada will be able to relieve that pressure, but what a series of plays.
Pichot, he taps quickly, John Tate lets him go. Quickly up by Eddie Fairhurst. Well, good thinking by Eddie Fairhurst. Ball spurts out Canada's side. Clears the touch, and this is probably the half. There it is.
So
half
Williams
time.
Is able to clear for touch, and Canada dodges one there as Pichot fell inches short of the goal line. But the Pumas lead 11-3. First half of action done. Solid game by both. Bit flat at the beginning, Gary. But we'll be looking for obviously different things in the second half, so Dave Clark will have a chance to talk to the boys. Now down to Craig McEwen.
One player who isn't in the side today, who played the first two games, is Mike Schmidt. And Mike, what is your sense of this first half for your side?
We're trying to play a lot of rugby out here, and at the moment we're one pass away from really making things happen. You know, the boys have stuck to the game plan quite well, and we're attacking these guys, which we need to do. And you know, hopefully this half we can retain a bit more possession and be on top of the scoreboard.
Great. Best of luck to you in the second half. Thanks very much, Mike. Your score here at Fletcher's Field at the break is 11-3 for Argentina. A Sports Central update with RJ Broadhead is coming up next, plus more rugby. Please do stay tuned.
And welcome back to Fletcher's Fields. Halftime score, Argentina leading Canada 11-3. And Gary, the first half of action, there wasn't a lot of it, but when we saw some, it was very exciting. And it was Argentina with the only try of the match. And it was all started by Pichot flipping out to Miranda. Miranda cutting back inside Scott Stewart, keeping the ball alive, faking, running inside of Snow, and then Pichot, the orchestrator, making things happen. Contempe ducking, and great hands by Deschazelle, the prop, and Sam Bussetti in the corner.
Yes, Mark, I think Pichot leading the attack once again, but I was amazed from the big prop, the loose head prop, getting the ball, flicking it off Sam Bussetti. Eddie Ferris is no match for that lock.
So Argentina holds the lead 11-3. First half action done, and we'll be back with second half action from the 2001 Visa Pan American Rugby Championship Series right after this. And welcome back to Fletcher's Field, Markham, Ontario. Mark Docherty alongside with Gary Johnston. And Gary, we can see the Canadian team huddled. What do you think Dave Clark is saying to them at the half break there?
Well, I think the few things that have to change. One, we have to get our lineups in order. We have to win our lineup ball, and we've got to pressure their lineup ball. He will continue to run the Argentinians around. He'd like to move the ball, I know, outside at a brisk pace, keep them moving, wait for the holes to open up. He'll be happy with what John Cannon's done in holding possession. Freddie Yazin, you want to spring him. He's there for his offensive threat. He's got to show it. In that first half, Mark, there was not one Canadian set scrum that we got to put the ball in. The one that we got to put it in, the Pumas came in early, they were penalized. We've not had one set scrum in the first half. You don't see that very often in a rugby game.
And that's an unbelievable statistic, and as the Pumas take back to the pitch, do you think Canada has to be at least pleased that although they haven't played well in the first half of action, the score is still only 11-3 for the Pumas?
Yes, I think they have to be pleased with that. The Pumas did do more of the play, but the play's been stopped, start by the referee, by whistles. Maybe the players are doing that. Is the referee, is there too many whistles? Can you put that whistle in his pocket for a while and let the game flow a bit? Some referees have the ability to motivate players to not infringe by talking. I think there's a bit of a resistance by the Argentine team to what El Camp has to say. And if they keep infringing, will he stop calling it and just let the game go, or will he stick to his guns and call it every single time?
Yeah, so far it's been a match with not a lot of flow to it, but we're hoping obviously for things to change. As the Pumas seem to be taking their time coming out of the change room now. Canada has been on the field for a few minutes now. They had a huddle outside the change room. Now they're taking to the pitch. So perhaps a tactic by the Pumas to slow things down, taking advantage here.
Well, no doubt. I think they control the thing. The referee doesn't control it. They are the Pumas. They're the higher ranked side. They're in the quarter. They're already in the quarter. The World Cup. They qualified by reaching the quarterfinals last time, and you know, they've never lost the para tournament. They think that they're in control now. What Dave Clark talked about, the hot-blooded Continentals, if they lose control, if they lose patience with El Camp, that'll be to Canada's advantage. Canada will not lose control. There's no doubt they're a well-disciplined side. They're not going to give up the silly penalties. And I think Ryan Banks is there to give them a little bit of niggle, and he certainly did. So let's see if we can get them off the boil and get some offensive ball handling by Canada. So here we go, the ball in contact, which we are keeping track of. That's not so-so. What that is significant is that we haven't had the ball very much. We won 24, we lost 5. We only had the ball 29 times in contact.
So the referee will be looking to sort things out in the front row as they've had trouble with the scrums. As the Pumas get ready to kick things off for the second half of action, the 2001 Visa Pan American Rugby Championship Series and the final, two countries undefeated, Canada and Argentina. The Pumas leading 11-3, and we're underway second half action. There's a little indecision there by Canada, but Ed Nags will pick it up inside the 22. Fairhurst finds Stewart, who has the time and gets away a good kick. Great clearance by Scotty Stewart. First kick of the second half, and he'll bring them just outside the 10-meter mark, but still inside the Canadian half.
Well, just looking over the Canadian team, I don't see any change in the lineup, so no changes for the Canadian team yet.
Red give out, no hold, red give out.
There's a significant statistic right there, is we have taken a couple of balls from Argentina, but they've had the ball more than we've had the ball. and that must change in the second half.
So far, Juan Jose Bechar has been very accurate, the lineout, and continues into the second half as the Pumas drive. Good control here by the pack, keeping it tight. Alvarez wheeling. Good recycling. Dande in there for the Pumas. Ball pops through though, so Canada with an advantage, and here comes Alcheron running into Rolando Martin. Canada looking to move it wide, but Scotty Stewart forced to kick it back, but does not find touch. And here comes Camardon. He'll hoist the up and under it, only travels about 10 meters.
All those players are offside, Mark. Every one of those Argentine players cannot be put onside, and there's no call from the referee.
So Alcheron picks it up for Canada, and Eddie Fairhurst, who saw that there was no winger in the back there as Camardon had come up with the up and under attempt. So Canada not receiving the penalty, but
this is tragic. This player, Argentinian player, was well in front of the 22, and it should be a lineup back where he kicked it from. Argentinian coach would be very happy with that decision. I don't know how they could make that mistake unless the ball was touched.
So it looks as though the ball may have been touched on the clearance attempt. So therefore, Argentina award the lineout. Bechar.
We got a call from the touch judge saying the ball was touched by the Canadian player. But those Argentinian players were all offside on that kick.
So Eddie Fairhurst had been up pressuring the kick. This time knocked forward by the Pumas. So scrum down Canada. We'll see if they've sorted things out in the locker room, Gary, in the first scrum of the match in the second half. Bonorino, Bichal, Deschazelle against Snow, Dunkley, and Teal. Nice and solid this time. Stewart back inside to Cannon, who's through the gap. Now he's looking outside and back inside for support. Sidestep finds Gregor Dixon, who straight arms his man. Canada on the advantage here, but penalty being called against Canada, so that will kill the momentum and change possession as Miranda.
Now what a great big fight, John Cam. Looking left, looking right, sidestepping inside, looking for support. Gregor Dixon, captain of Canada 17, picks up the ball, going to head. Our player's going to go down, yes. Player's diving on top of Dix. Mark Irvine diving on top of, he had to hold his feet. Diving on top of the player on the ground. Bridging, and it will be called. But that was a great break by John Canada. Shows what Canada can do when they have the ball and their space.
We saw it against the Eagles in the first match. A lot of the backs for Canada have sevens experience, very explosive.
You're in the arm.
Very good runners, but now once again Canada penalized. As Roldan has a chuckle, but Argentina will have a shot at goal here.
Well, this would be an extremely difficult kick. He's kicking into a cross breeze from 40 meters out. But he's decided he can make it. So Canada will watch for the rebounds off the post.
So Contepome with the tee and the penalty attempt for the Pumas. They lead the match 11-3. Early second half action. This is the final of the Pan American Rugby Championship Series between these two countries, both undefeated. Contepome for the penalty. And he's hit it well, but it falls short just in front of the post, and Freddie Assen will touch it down. They'll bring it out. Scotty Stewart sees a hole. It's partially blocked and will fall into the hands of Contepome, who missed the penalty at Kemp. And unfortunately for Ed Fairhurst, ricocheted off his hands.
Now Canada's a very difficult situation here. They've got to stop the Argentinian team from driving this line out. They can stop it at the source and try to compete against their possession. If they don't, they must knock down the catcher of this ball.
So the Pumas, who have had good success in their lineouts, deep inside the 5 meter mark of Canada. Bichard looking for Sambusetti. didn't find him, but it's cleaned up by the forwards, and Dande runs straight into Teal and Snow, but the Pumas set up. Pumas just outside the Canadian 5 meter is Pichot to Miranda.
That was great defense by Canada, and a knock-on forced a knock-on when they moved the ball to the outside backs. Very good defense by Canada, knocking down the rollers of that mall.
So that's twice now, as Arango looks disappointed, but that's twice, Gary, that Canada has been, or Argentina rather, has been in tight, and Canada's defense has come through.
Canada's defense has stopped them close to the line, so they forced them to move the ball to the backs where they made a mistake.
And Fairhurst took it to ground, but Argentina over the top. So the Pumas will be penalized, and Gregor Dixon, quick tap and go, running in to Roldan. Stewart to Williams, looking for space, jinking sideways, links with Chiron. Nags to settle. Fairhurst has men outside with Stewart. As Pat Dunkley and Irvine ran into each other with John Cannon in the mix, and they've turned the ball over with the knock-on. So Canada, Gary, obviously anxious to attack in the back line, perhaps a little too anxious.
Well, Canada's looking to spread the ball wide and run and look for the holes, and it's hard to kick out of the 22 with this breeze. So they're still looking for holes. Now they've got to play some defense.
Puma's still inside the Canadian half, as Fairhurst does a good job of taking Dande to the ground, the number 8, and here goes Rolando Martin. Pumas will move it wide. Miranda with the left-footed drop goal from way out. And what a kick by Miranda. Huge drop goal, second of the match. And Argentina now leading Canada 14-3. And Gary, I didn't think that had a chance, but what a huge kick by Miranda.
Well, the wind is blowing across the field from the right to the left, and he takes this ball on the right side of the field. Left-footed drop kicker, it was a sweet hit, and it just carried through the uprights. 14-3 Argentina. Canada needs to score to get back into this game.
Pumas let it drop, and just unfortunate bounce for Al Chiron as he was coming through.
So the Pumas aren't making mistakes. We just have to capitalize on the mistakes they make and keep the pressure on them. Here's a chance for the Pumas to clear, you see. Good solid set scrum.
Pumas drive it forward, collapses, and they'll reset it.
Bring it over here.
Scrum down. It's on the Pumas 22, and the referee will go confer with the touch judge, who's perhaps seeing something on the blind side.
It's against you, Blue. Touch judge called Blue tight head, bringing down. No, back away. No.
So you heard the tight head.
No, back away.
For Argentina, back away. Bringing the scrum down. Penalty here. This is extremely. This is a kickable kick. Scotty Stewart's calling for the. This is the ball in contact again. 34 wins. The Canadian player taking the ball into contact and able to produce it 7 times. They were not able to produce it.
So the problems continue in the front rows. Problems with the scrums for both countries. This time Canada receiving the advantage with the penalty called against the Pumas. And a kickable kick for Scott Stewart.
Dave Steele, who's on the Canadian panel, so he knows his stuff. He's called the Puma tight head, pulling the scrum down, coming in at an angle.
3 points for Canada so far from the boot of Scott Stewart, who's 1-for-2 today. But a good opportunity to put Canada up 3 more. Struck it well, and he struck it true, and 3 more for Canada. So they narrow the gap, but the Pumas still leading 14-6. Second half action. The crowd responds to the score by Canada as Scotty Stewart trying to marshal the troops.
Scotty Stewart with 61 international caps. He is a team leader. He wants the energy level up, and the crowd can give him some energy. Canada does something exciting. The crowd will be in it.
Well, Canada needed a score. They got it with the penalty. But they're looking for tries. Zal Charron takes it well. Settles it for Fairhurst. Takes his time. Finds Stewart. Right foot off the side of it. He's not happy with that. Not a lot of distance. So the Pumas now with a good opportunity to attack as some of their substitutes start to warm up.
I know he's frustrated, but...
Line out Pumas. Just outside the Canadian 22.
That's the tail of possession. 2-1.
Bashar trying to get the line out call clear. And he finds his man Alvarez. And the drive is on by the Pumas inside the Canadian 22. They wheel it around. Held in by Dande, waiting for support. Taken on by Roldan and Sambusetti. Pichot now moves it wide. Miranda. But De Pome missed with Arongo. Came through in a big hit. But the ball popped to Scortoni. And Charron wrestles him to the ground. But the Pumas still with the ball, but stolen now by Canada. And another solid defensive effort by Canada as they clear. Scotty Stewart, right foot, finds touch. So the Pumas looking dangerous, but once again, you talked about it off the top of the show, Gary, that straight line defense coming up, doing what they're supposed to do.
And Canada to the breakdown quicker than Argentina. Canada to the breakdown quicker and gaining support. El Chiron, first man across. Freddie Aslan, they're trying to dig the ball loose. It comes back. There's Dixon, slides to Freddie Aslan. Dixon working together, getting the ball. Now Canada's possession. There's a drive by Ryan Banks. On the Canada 40, Mark. On the Canada 40. Argentine ball.
Good defense by Canada, but it will be the Pumas' lineup. Alvarez does a good job to knock it back, but they'll call the knock-on by Canada. So now scrum down, Pumas. 15 in.
White in the 15.
So Canada is putting pressure on the Argentine on the lineup ball. Their scrums are much more solid, and they'll enjoy this possession a lot more than the scattered possession they're getting from lineups.
Dande links with Pichot, chips it through. Bartolucci gives chase. Up comes Williams, and Bartolucci can't hang on. Advantage being played for Canada. Now they'll mount the counterattack. Tossed out to Freddie Aslan, one-on-one. Inside, outside. Looking for support, finds Cannon. Canada, across the field. Still with the advantage. Ball's live now, Charron with good hands. Finds Rod Snow. This is good work by Canada. The ball comes out to Scott Stewart. Makes a move and finds Sean Faulk. He's taken down, but it's picked up by Canada. And this is tremendous work by the Canadian forwards in support.
So unfortunate, just an obstruction call, and not accidental. It's called deliberate obstruction, the Canadian player being in front of the ball carrier.
So once again, some great work by Canada. Goes unrewarded as a simple mistake. They lose possession.
Canada do a lot of good work, but it's inside their own half. They've got to get out of their half and do that kind of work in the Pumas' half.
Restart by Canada. Scortoni, the right foot. But Williams there to take it. And here comes Williams. Taking on Scortoni. Tried to find support. Gets it through his legs to Scotty Stewart.
And it's Canada ball. So they played it back off the leg of the Puma.
So Conte Pome, who came over to make the tackle against Stewart, goes off his leg as we have a look at Bartolucci, and oh so close to getting through for the try for Argentina.
The fans wanting to get behind. It's right in front of the main stands here that's filled. Wanting to get behind Canada. Give them some energy.
Dunkley to the back and finds Teal. Stewart to Cannon. Takes on two Pumas. Produces the ball for Fairhurst, who finds Banks straight into his man. Canada has some numbers outside, but Stewart opts for the kick. Scortoni with a good take. Right foot to touch. Canada's line out. We have.
There's a Puma on the ground. It might be the reciprocate of Ryan Banks' straight arm when he went into contact.
Argentine player down.
Both teams get a break. We're still not on the halfway point in the second half. About 16 minutes gone. I think the next score will be crucial if it can be Canada's. Even if it's a penalty, we're back in the game. If it's to Argentina, it makes it a tough last quarter. Canada just has not had possession inside the Pumas' half, where they're able to recycle the ball and run and make penetration. A lot of our stuff is done inside our half.
So once again, Dante Pome, he's not had a very good day with Ryan Banks. Once again involved in an altercation.
Oh, so this is a call from the sidelines, and they're talking to Dunkley.
Give me 7 minutes, 10 minutes.
Okay. We've got to get a replacement hooker on the field. Dunkley's going to sin bin. So the call is that Pat Dunkley used his knee and hit Contepani in the head. And he'll go to the sin bin for 10 minutes, which means Canada will have to send off a player and bring in a replacement hooker.
So the Pumas, for the second time in the match, a man advantage as Pat Dunkley is forced to take a seat in the sin bin for 10 minutes.
Well, Dale Burley will warm up and get into the game as soon as possible. Who David Clark takes off, I'm not sure. But for the next set scrum, you'll see Dale Burley packing down between Rod Snow and John Teal.
So Puma's inside the Canadian 22 with the drive on. Canada man down. Puma's taking advantage. Recycling, moving, Pichot. Advantage was being played, but now Canada will be penalized.
Calling Rod Snow from coming into the side from the side.
No, it was one red.
This is Dale Burley warming up.
Oh, put it on.
He received his first cap on Wednesday night against Uruguay and played well. He's a tough, hard competitor. So here comes Rod. So this is what Ryan Banks. That's what I thought might have done it, but it wasn't that. Dunkley drives in. I don't see anything here. The flag's out immediately by the touch judge, so he's called something after the initial hit by Dunkley and Ryan Banks.
Huge lineout for the Pumas. 5 meter mark of Canada. Ball pops out Pichot to Miranda. Back inside to Arango, who's met by Scotty Stewart. Canada trying to steal the ball, but they'll call it all the way back.
It's calling Canada for dumping the mall. It was something that was discussed before the game. The first man can take it down, but after the first man, Argentina chooses a scrum. Canada player short. Will they bring in a player to the scrum?
So a huge scrum for Canada. Argentina with the man advantage. Once again, hooker Pat Dunkley in the sin bin for an infraction. 10 minutes. It couldn't have come at a more crucial part of the game as Burley tries to come onto the pitch.
Burley has to come on the pitch. He can't scrummage without a hooker.
So finally they let Burley come on for his
second cap.
Second cap for Canada. Talk about pressure coming straight in as they'll take off Freddie Asselin to allow Burley to come on into the front row for Canada with what has to be the pivotal scrum of the match, Gary, with Canada down 14-6, one man down, and a huge opportunity for the Pumas.
I would expect the Pumas to try to push Canada over here, having a player advantage.
They'll reset it.
The referee is under huge pressure to make a call and he won't allow the scrum to continue to go down without making a call.
Let's see, Hugo Dande talking to Pichot, perhaps a move in the back row as Dande picks up, but he's taken to the ground quickly. Argentina still with the ball, Pichot, Miranda. Contepome, able to secure ball for the Pumas. But have they lost it? Canada, once again, unbelievable defense, and they've managed a turnover. Irvine with the left foot, but does not find touch. Stortoni looked to bobble, but play continues. A little chip kick through, and he's able to catch it as he's absolutely hammered by Sharon. Looked to be a clean tackle, so I don't think Sharon will be penalized.
Surely there was nothing wrong with that. Man and ball arriving at the same time, a big hit by Al Sharon.
So the captain for Canada sending a message to Argentina that, hey, we're still in this thing.
Chip kick Argentina, retrieving his own chip kick, hit by Sharon. Nags is in there supporting. Good play by Canada. 20 minutes into the half. Ed Nags is down. And they won't be able to scrummage without him in there. Lock.
So Ed Nags receives some attention as
Nova Scotia boy. Coming to Canada last year. He's a workhorse in the set scrum and around the field.
So on comes a replacement for Argentina. Morales comes in. Huge come for Canada once again.
The scrum's got to be stable before Ed Ferris puts the ball in.
No, no. When it's steady, please put it in. In five. In five. Hold. Engage. Put it now.
Good pickup by Banks. Takes on Miranda. Crashes through. Canada will move the ball. Irvine, the cannon. Quick hands to Williams, who was under all kinds of pressure. Got the pass away. Great work there by Irvine, who was able to get the ball back for Canada's Fairhurst. Towering kick. Stortoni is forced to make circus-like catches. He throws it forward, though. Advantage Canada as Burley moved it back. So Canada, Stortoni makes the great catch and then throws it forward. So Canada will get the scrum down just inside their half, but relieving all kinds of pressure.
Nice high kick by Eddie Ferris. The Canadian player is getting under that ball, putting the pressure on the Pumas. However, will the Canadian scrum hold?
Get up. Bring it up. Moving forward. Scrum.
See, now, whether Canada want to get the ball to the backs, they're a player short in the forwards. There's no flanker on that side. They're playing, either is Al Sharon on one side. There's no flanker on the open side. We're equally matched in the backs, and we're down one in the forwards for four or five more minutes.
So they'll reset the scrum.
Gregor Dixon has moved to the backs, which is no problem for him.
Fairhurst. Scotty Stewart to Cannon, who runs into Miranda. Pumas up quickly. Canada once again lucky there to maintain possession as the Pumas seem to have actually gained the advantage coming forward, but they'll get the scrum.
On a ruck ball, it goes to the team that took the ball into the ruck.
Fairhurst to Williams, playing the advantage. What a sidestep by Williams. Got the ball out, trying to connect with Foth. They'll bring it back, but advantage was being played, so Canada with the penalty.
Shoulder charge by Argentina, not using their arms in the tackle. That's illegal.
Quick tap, and right to Rod Snow, who goes through Bonorino to set up Stewart. Has been outside, decides to keep himself. He's looking for support. Sharon is there. Once again, Canada going forward. They'll receive the scrum. This is better stuff from the Canadians.
Well, they're attacking. They're trying to find the holes. They just got to get that second phase ball quickly so they can go more than once.
Once again, Canada a man short. Pat Dunkley in the sin bin for an infraction. Cannon managed to hang on, and he's taken down by Martin. But Produce. Scotty Stewart tried to switch fields, but it was partially blocked, and here come the Pumas. Deschazelle runs into his own man. Incidental contact, but it will cost the Pumas. And Canada, once again, Kerry, gets a good call.
It's about 2 minutes to go until Dunkley's back on and Canada's at full strength. There are several players down. John Teal's down. There's Pat Dunkley and Fred Adams, and they'll probably both come on together. Ed Nags is down again for the second time. Time is stopped, and Pat Dunkley's 10-minute suspension is stopped as well. Now it starts again.
Scrum down, Canada. They look to move it. They bobble. A little trouble between the exchange of Banks and Fairhurst as to who was going to pick that up. And once again, it's those little mistakes that start mounting up, Gary, and can cost you in the end.
Well, it's a change of possession. That's what hurts. Change of possession. And we had decent field position.
Pichot. Miranda with the left foot. Williams comes charging over. He'll let that come inside his 22 and will look for touch. Finds touch easily. And on come Pat Dunkley and Freddie Aslin. So Pat Dunkley has served his penance in the sin bin, and Freddie Aslin will be allowed to come on as well as Burley came in to the front row for Canada. So Canada able to keep the Pumas off the board somewhat while Dunkley sat on the bench. Deschazelle still doing extremely well in the lineouts. The Pumas now drive, but offside against Canada, and this is kickable if they decide to go for that. So Conte Pome has opted for the post. He'll try the penalty kick. Argentina leading Canada, 14-6. Second half action. This is the final match of the 2001 Pan American Rugby Championship Series. Both teams undefeated. Argentina looking to add some insurance. And he struck it well, and he curled it just inside the left post. So the Pumas now up 17-6. Edging closer, the Pumas have never lost a Pan American Rugby Series Championship. The holders of the cup. Canada, though, has beaten the Pumas in two matches previous to this one.
One in Argentina and one in Canada. And if they're going to win today, they need some points quickly. They need a try quickly.
So we wait for the ball to come back into play. Scott Stewart.
Now the last kickoff, Argentina let it bounce. See if they'll do that again for us.
Once again, Scott Stewart. And a huge hit by Alcheron, sending a message. Trying to get his team to follow the example, and Canada with possession. Now inside the Pumas, 22. The ball is there. Stewart moves it wide to Cannon. Back inside to Irvine, who tried to link with Williams through a dangerous pass back. It's picked up and brought down by Freddie Aslin. Looked to go off the Puma player, but we'll have to wait to see who the lineout goes to. And
the player that hit Alcheron hit is still lying on the field.
I believe it's Alvarez, who's down for the Pumas. And Sharon just came in and rocked him off the drop, out off the restart.
Well, I think that's one of El Sharon's trademarks, to put that kick up nice and high, come in hard, and once the man catches the ball, he's fair game. Here we'll see the tackle right here. Beautiful hit, beautiful timing on El Sharon, nothing wrong with that. Turnover to Canada, Canada's ball. Al Sharon leading by example.
Canada definitely needs to see more of that. And we wait to see if Alvarez will be all right. He's still on the ground. There's an anxious Argentine coach looks on. And
well, I think, Mark, what Canada has to do now, we've got to get the next score. We've got to get the next score. We've got to get a ball across the try line. Get Canada back into the game. We have a chance of beating the Pumas today. We're not into the last half of the last half yet. About 10 minutes to go, about 20 minutes gone, so we've got about 12 minutes to go. The rain started to fall. Got a shower coming down. It's going to be extremely difficult for Canada to get the try they need to get them back in the game.
So far throughout the tournament, we had been lucky with the weather. And hopefully this is just a passing shower. As rain does begin to trickle here in Markham. Alvarez gives the thumbs up. He's going to stay on the pitch, but play continues now as it's taken by Dixon. Cleaned up by Ed Fairhurst. Canada's scrum half in the mix right now. Rod Snow's driven back.
Argentina has been good defensively. They make the tackle, man on his feet, has to be given the ball. Rod doesn't want to. So penalty, Argentina. Argentina's been solid defensively. As we probe them, we try them. They make the one-on-one tackles, they knock our players on the ground.
So once again, Canada had the advantage. They had won the lineout inside the Pumas half, but another mistake, costly, as the Puma is able to capitalize. Kick for touch as we see the Puma replacement. Durand is, or rather, Canalda. In for the Pumas. And indeed, while Alvarez gave the thumbs up earlier, he is now on the bench after that crunching tackle by Al Sharon.
Get over here.
The referee will call in Ryan Banks and Al Sharon as the player for Argentina is down.
August Pierre, their captain, their leader, professional player of Bristol. He's got the cards right, out.
He's coming after, throwing the ball. He went after him, he took a shot at his head. They're off.
He's off. So it's a red card. So Ryan Banks has been sent off. Canada will have to play. There's no replacing Ryan Banks. And Canada will have to play a man short for the last 10 minutes of the game.
So at the critical juncture of this game, Gary, the last 10 minutes with Canada trailing 17-6. This time they'll lose a player.
Let's see, oh, there, yes. Okay, you see that. And Pichot knows that if he hits like that, he better stay down and get the call. So that's a fair call by the referee. Pichot's nowhere near the ball. David Clark will be upset with that because it cost Canada any chance of winning this game, having to win with 14 players.
So Banks will have a seat. He is done for the day. He is not in the sin bin, he is gone, ejected from this match after elbowing Augustin Pichot, the captain for the Pumas. Pumas with a man advantage, Pichot to Miranda. He'll try another drop kick, this time with the right foot and one with the left, one with the right, and what a drop kick. Drop goal by Miranda.
Now there's very few players in the world can drop kick with both feet. Mark Wyatt was one, the point getter for Canada in two World Cups. to lovely timing, right-footed kick. And Miranda, three more points, brings the score to 20-6 for Argentina. All-out effort from Canada. They will go right to the end. That's in their nature. And will they be rewarded with a try?
Miranda, this time with the left foot, looking for touch. As Freddie Aslan's able to keep it in play. And once again, one-on-one, he'll have a go. Chip through. It's bobbled by Roldan, and here comes Canada with pressure, but Pichot reverses the field after a little spin move and links up with Orongo.
Now, the ref's going to have to take a strong stand in this game, otherwise it'll get out of control.
Canada will have to settle things down.
There's Pichot reversing the field, coming back, looking for support. Mark Irvine makes the tackle. Gregor Dixon, nothing wrong there. It's something off the play that's been called from the touch judge.
And you could just see Fairhurst come in and completely take out Pichot. So Pichot has been taken out twice by Canadian players. One of them resulting in Ryan Banks being ejected from this match.
Now, I can see how Kemp does not want to send another player off. I mean, another yellow card. He's just going to award a penalty. Asking the touch judge, what do you think?
So Fairhurst, fortunate to not receive a card. Miranda to clear with the penalty. So Canada starting to unravel here as they trail the Pumas. 20-6, late stages of the second half. The Pan American Rugby Championship on the line. 10-meter mark of Canada. Vichard, the lineout for the Pumas. As you can see, 18-6. Unbelievable advantage, and that's taken well by Sambusetti. And the Pumas move it wide. Conde Pome. Pichot digs. Back inside to Vichard. Canada has turned the ball over once again, and they'll move it wide. Irvine trying to sidestep his tackle, but they'll bring it back off the knock-on. So Canada will get the ball back, scrum down. But Canada in desperate need of some offense. As you can see,
Mark
blood
Irvine
pouring from the head of Irvine. As he's obviously been cut, and he'll have to come to the sideline. So blood substitution will come in.
So play will stop, and the replacement in the center could be Bob Ross, or it could be Marco Di Girolamo. He may opt to go to Scott Stewart in the center and Bob Ross at number 10. But those are the two replacements. David Clark's connected with walkie-talkie to the trainers down below. So here we go, Mark Irvine going forward. Head looks okay right now. There's the tackle right there. He must have caught a cleat the side of his head. Totally accidental, but it will require Marco Di Girolamo coming on for his second cap, a scrum half with the Pacific Pride in Victoria.
As Irvine heads off to the sideline.
8 minutes left to go in the game.
Scrum down Canada, but they're pushed back by the Pumas once again, but they managed to get the ball out. Stewart fakes and keeps himself, looking for support, none there, goes to ground. Canada slow to get there to the breakdown, Gary, and penalized because Stewart could not let go of the ball.
Right, nobody supporting Stewart on the break, and so therefore he held onto the ball, and it was a just call. Canada again getting himself in trouble. Support players have to be there. Scott Stewart making the break. There's got to be somebody with him. Marco Di Girolamo, second cap for Canada. Again, ball in contact. We've had the ball more in the second half than the first half. 64 times we produced it, 8 times we lost it.
So Conte Pome will look to add some insurance. The Pumas leading 20-6. Time almost out of this match. Time almost out for Canada in this year's 2001 Pan American Rugby Championship Series. Fontepome, rather, as you can see, is missed to the left of the post. Dropout 22. Canada needing to make things happen. Stewart, the dropout. Taken by Deschazal. Puma's looking to attack the blind side. Pichot, Miranda, linking with Bartolucci. Pichot once again. Back inside, knocked forward by the Pumas. Advantage Canada. They'll want to use this and get it wide. Teal rumbling into Martin. Fairhurst to Stewart to Cannon. Looking for an opening, anything. But he's stood up well by him.
No free, just knock, guys.
No advantage. Going back to the original knock-on set scrum Canada. John Cannon looking for holes, just not being able to find him in the second half.
Pumas up quickly on defense, shutting down the opportunities to move it wide. Williams as well, not had a lot of daylight to work with. Canada wins the scrum. Stewart trying to move it wide. Williams trying to make things happen inside his 22, but he's hammered and driven back hard. Canada does a good job to hold the ball. They'll try again. Foth to Cannon. Gets through one tackle and gets it outside to Teal and Snow, who are out on the wings but are not going to break any track records. But look at Teal. What great support and great movement by Canada. Looking for more. They have the numbers if they can get it out wide. Freddie Aston looking to scissors, gets it to Williams, back inside to Ed Nags, straight into Martin. This is great stuff by Canada, but they lose the ball. Stortoni. His hit, knocked forward by Canada, but once again, Canada can't keep it going, and that's it. The match over, Argentina victorious, 20-6 the final score, and Gary, give Argentina full credit. The winners of the 2001 Pan Am Rugby Champions, they hold the cup again.
Well, there have been three previous championships. Argentina's won them all. They were the best team in the tournament. Canada came in with high hopes, but they just didn't perform today. Now, that may be a product of Argentina playing solid defense and not letting Canada get on the board, especially in the first half. Canada tried to the end, but it was just indicative when that last little breakout, and they go, the ball goes to Ed Nags. One guy brings him down, the other guy takes the ball from him, change of possession. So the 100 or so Argentina fans that are here, who made lots of noise, will be extremely happy with the result. For Canada, they'll live to fight another day, and I'm sure they'll be looking forward to England next week.
So a tough loss for Canada as they drop it to Argentina, 20-6 the final score. We'll be back with post-game reaction from the Pan American Rugby Championship Series right after this.